Afternoon to one and all. I like to thank the organizers for giving us the opportunity to explore our research findings in the very eminent forum. And this forum, I have to appreciate the organizers for giving the importance to the current scenario on healthcare materials and development, especially the current novel technologies with reference to stem cell therapy and stem cell research. I like to say that we are not a physician. We are a fundamental basic researcher as a biological researcher, and I am from Central Leather Research Institute. Our research is mainly focused on developing biological materials to support the healthcare. That is our major research, and we started our research with the collagen based material. We know that skin is nothing but the collagen, since Leather Institute is involving in transformation of animal skin to leather. Our biology group is involved in development of collagen based material for human healthcare. So we developed a very good technologies and other things, and our current research, what I am going to talk about, is mainly the innovative research. It receives a very good attention from the worldwide. First thing, it contains three different types of information. I can start my research with the wounds, because we earlier concentrate on wounds, how far we can able to manage the wounds, in what way we can able to get rid of wound care, get use of wound care materials. And with the reference to types of wounds, we have so many number of types of wounds, but the major, our focus is mainly on the internal wounds, because the internal wounds, surgical wounds, are mainly challenges for the physician to do the sutures and other things, and moreover, no kind of material to approximate the tissues. So for that reason, we started working with the internal wounds, and these are the different kinds of wounds, and we are targeting all these kinds of wounds through kind of material development. And the prime importance with the reference to wound care material preparation is, first we have to protect the wound from microbial infections, and we have to provide the wound covers with some suitable healing agents, and we have to clean the wound periodically. If you are going to just give an introduction on the skin, we know that there is a three different layers, and the percentage of damages, how far it can affect the skin. And with reference to collagen, because this is the most important material, what we are exposing with that collagen, and this is a number of human collagen molecule has been explored. And I am proud to say that CLRI is involved in developing the wound care material in terms of amniotic collagen, and it has been provided to the fire incident during 2014 at Kumbakonam, and we can support the people to recover from these kind of injuries. And when you are going to talk about collagen, we know that the great scientist G.N. Ramachandran, he has only revealed the triple helical structure of that collagen, and after that it has been, but before that there is a very good 1913 amnion wound repair has been in reports, but still we are just struggling with whether we can use amnion or not, because of so many number of ethical issues and the infections related issues. A government it has been stopped in Chennai. We should not use this kind of amnion based materials. And when you are going to talk about the development of collagen based materials, it's a dressing materials come up on 1942, and heart valves has come up, and with reference to 85 we can able to go with the ASLR matrix methods. And with reference to wound care materials, we have started number of wound care materials. It starts from natural ceramics, and in post 1970s only we started working with the biomimetic case agents, so that we can able to have a biodegradable and biocompatible materials. And when you are going to talk about the healing of wounds, there is we know that particularly that is, since it starts with the hemostasis, inflammation and proliferative, whatever the wound care materials what we are going to develop, we should just concentrate on reducing the inflammations, as well as it should support the proliferation and also the remodeling, where all those, the scar formation and other things can be, we can able to avoid. And if we can able to delay the inflammation, then it leads to so many number of biochemical events over there. And the most important thing is, it is, as already we come to know that ECM, that is extracellular matrix development, how far we can able to mimic the ECM, that is most important in the case of wound is concerned. So what we thought, we can able to mimic the ECM through kind of collagen based materials. And with the reference to wound care material, these are the requirements, the prerequisites for the any kind of wound care materials. and the challenges, whether it is possible to get back the original ECM, what is the possibility and how we are going to achieve, and what is our actual requirement. The requirements, we have to have very good building materials and it should have a high mechanical stability. That is the most important aspect of the research. And as the materials in front, we know that collagen from any kind of bovine, fish, avian, and polysaccharides are also there. Synthetic polymers, natural fibers, synthetic fibers, even nowadays the composites are also in lineup in materials for wound care. And what we thought, as already I told that, we are going to concentrate on internal wounds. Internal wounds is a dynamic wounds. The flow will be there, and if the environment is so wet, how we are going to make it, how we can able to avoid the suturing. So what we thought, we can go with the collagen and then we can conjugate. We are using some engineering methods. We have to conjugate with that one. What is a kind of conjugation? Why we want to do conjugation? So conjugation is a kind of interaction with the materials as well as the proteins, so that it can able to increase the mechanical stability of that materials. So how we can able to make it in the sense is that this is from the nature. If you can able to go through the muscle adhesive proteins, there you can see that it can able to develop a very good adhesive towards the wet environment. That protein is highly strong and it is not leaving the muscles from the ship. It can go and adhere even with the high flow of water. The tidal force is there. So what we thought, what is the kind of protein so that we can look into that? And we started working on that, this kind of muscle proteins, how it can able to adhere on the wet surface. And we just want to mimic that protein. And we have taken the collagen and collagen hydrolysate, and then we have interacted with the phenolic acids through normal bioconjugation chemistry. And based on that, we have developed a conjugated, there is a caffeic acid conjugated gel. That gel can, and it has been characterized accordingly how far the chemical interaction is fruitful or not. And based on that, we did all the biochemical and chemical analysis. And once we have prepared, we can able to see that, this material, when in solution it is there, but when in contact with the kind of some tyrosinase or some kind of oxidizing agent, it can immediately transform into a gel. Even you can able to reduce the time within a second if you want, you can able to transform into a gel, or if you want to have a relaxed time, based on the percentage of gel composition, you can able to reduce the time, whatever the time you need to close the wounds. And so this is actual mechanism, overall schematic approach it has been made by us. And based on that, we have made, this is a kind of soft gel, and it is how far the storage modulus is there. It is changing with the reference to the percentages and with the reference to the swelling, because it really, it also mimics the ECM in such a way that it can able to accommodate to the cells, or it can able to accommodate the body fluids and other things. And the hemocompatibility has been studied in such a way using human in fibroblast cells. And because it is necessary for whatever the wound care materials we are preparing, it is need to be degraded or not, otherwise it will lead to some other issues. So that we want to study the degradability of this material, and also this molecule, whether it has some anti-inflammatory, there is antimicrobial effect is there or not, we studied that one also. And how far it can able to support the migration of the cells, it has been studied. And we got a potential of effect of this CBG gel. After that, we did some in vitro biodegradation study, in vivo biodegradation studies, and we can able to see that once it has been given, it has been nicely degraded, and it doesn't affect any kind of cellular events, and it is not forming any kind of fibrosis. And these are the all the H&E sections. It has been obtained upon during the subcutaneous injection of that material. And once it has been done, all the physical biochemical analysis, we gone to how far it can able to replace the sutures. We just take the material and done in animal models, this incision wound. We have taken the fibrin sealant as the material as a comparison. And we have seen that it has been nicely, there is no sutures are involved, just we can apply and it can able to approximate the wound nicely. And even the wound strength is also found to be at an appreciable level. And once it has been done by in vivo studies in incision wound, we forward to that kind of open wound also. These are the other biochemical and histochemical events, how far this CBG gel can be able to support the healing of wounds. And this is the open wound. There also we found that it doesn't require any kind of sutures. It can be able to support the healing of wounds. And based on that, it has been developed. The technology has been developed by us. This is called BioGlue. It's a suture-free wound care product, and it has been transferred to the pharmaceutical company. And once it has been done, our main objective for the internal wounds. So we started work with the hernia model, and we have developed the hernia model in animals. And we done with the kind of stitch alone and as well as with the BioGlue materials. There we can able to see that hernia formation is completely controlled by this BioGlue treatment. And it's a quite a nice, interesting observations we done in so many number of, I think more than 108 animals we did. We got very good, interesting results. And in addition to that, whether the BioGlue can able to support the healing of bones also. So we did some animal model studies. We got interesting observations that is BioGlue can able to support the healing of bone wounds also. So once it has been done, we thought, okay, why can't we go into the this kind of canine model? And in canine model, it is not, we can't able to do the wounds and other things. So we approached the Blue Cross. There, whatever the animals, they are coming up with the different kinds of wounds. We started working on this kind of materials. We found a very good, interesting observations. All the animals are healed in such a way that they can able to go within 15 to 20 days. Otherwise, they can, the standard reagents what they have used is not supporting. Then this is the kind of, this is a video. It is there in the YouTube. You can able to see that. There is the innovation product, what it has been developed. It received the FICCI Gold Medal Winning Award. This is, once it has been done, this CBG gel what it have been prepared, we thought, okay, why can't we, it can be used for the stem cell differentiation into the neuronal moieties, and there we can able to find that how far the cells are viable inside it, how it has been encapsulated. Gambhir said there is a quite challenge in the kind of encapsulation, where the major challenge in stem cell therapy is where we are going to target, how it can be targeted, whether it will be transformed into a kind of ruckus what we are, but that's why we gone into the encapsulation of these mesenchymal stem cells, and we found that is a very good differentiation with the reference to the neuronal issues. And there you can see that this is CD90 is a market. It can inside the CBG gel we can deal with the human gingival mesenchymal stem cells, human umbilical mesenchymal stem cells. With the markers you can see that there is a very good differentiation, and it can be transferred into the neural lineages. So after that, this is the kind of the sum analysis. There you can see that how the cells have been there, and this is the histology as well as the neuronal markers, the nasal granules presentation over there in the inside the matrix. So it authentically says that the CBG gel can able to support the mesenchymal stem cells to adhere and as well as to differentiate. And once we did all the in vitro studies, we have taken that encapsulated cells into the animal model. We did some spinal cord injury, and we have incorporated that gel along with the differentiated cells. There we find the very good spinal cord repair, and that studies we couldn't able to show here. I have to thank my students who are all involved in this research. Thank you.